Hello, welcome back to Farming Simulator on Sosnovka. It's actually the same day I just finished harvesting on the last episode, but something fun happened. The biogas plant is ready to pay a considerably higher price for silage for the next 6 hours. So, let's do it. Fields planting, fields fertilizing, and I've got a front-end loader over here ready for silage. Silo number 3 is ready, and there's quite a bit in there. I've got a problem, though. I have tried recording a courseplay course for this 6-7 times at this point, and I just cannot get it to turn correctly. It keeps getting messed up between when it backs out, it loses the course. I don't know why. I think it's because there's such a limited distance between the beginning of the silo and the cell point right behind it. It doesn't really have enough space to do a lot of things. So, I had an idea. In the Norsholm series, I had a mod that I was using that I really kind of liked. It was a conveyor belt. So, I'm going to get, I don't know. Not sure if I want to do one or two of those. I'm going to start with one, though, just to kind of see how it goes. So, it's sitting there waiting for me. I'm going to grab this guy. Grab a trailer of some kind, just to make it easier to back up. I'll grab that guy. I'll take him over to the biogas plant, and should pick up in just a second. Alright. And then this guy, I need to go pick up the conveyor belt. That's at the start. This area, let's see if we have only 6 eggs. I want those 6. Let's find out. like it connected underneath. That's kind of interesting. I think that's... Did I just get it too close? No, it's just going to attach there. Okay, well... that's going to really limit my ability to turn this thing, isn't it? Heh. That could be complicated. I don't think that's going to work. So... gonna drop that weight. Actually, I wonder if... I do not know if this is gonna work. Let's, it's like I'm not getting under the weight. Okay. I'll leave that sitting there and come pick it up later. So I guess the transfer force ends over there. I forgot that I did that. That's okay. Alright, let's, I'm just gonna set the front end motor out of the way over here. I'll come back. Attach. up front? Yes, I can. I'm going to turn that on. And basically, I can use that tractor to move it around, and this tractor. Now, there's obviously a problem here. I need to move the conveyor to actually sell it, because unless something is very different than what I'm remembering, there is no trigger that the trailer can reach. But let's go check that just to be sure. I'm getting a detach, but I'm not getting an unload. Fill level 12%. Not sure what that is. But I'm not seeing anything around here that looks like a spot that the trailer can unload. I haven't actually taken this into the map editor yet to see if there's something I'm missing, but it looks like there's not one. So, in the interest of saving time, I think I'm just going to buy another conveyor. And I'm going to go get that off screen and come back. So, that was cheaper than last time, wasn't it? Okay, maybe it wasn't. Alright, I'll be back. Alright, we're back. And with the second conveyor. So let's get it up and ready. And I decided to set it up over this way, just to try to keep it from running into each other. Although it would be interesting to see if we could set up a, you know, conveyor chain to automatically do it. That might be fun later on. I'm not sure if I turn it on, will it stay active? That kind of seems like cheating, but let's find out. That front end loader is going to be right in the way now. Unload trigger. And it will stay active. That's kind of cool. Let's unload this thing for a bit. filling. I'll go check on everybody else. Looks like it didn't keep filling when I tapped off of it. That's interesting. That's nowhere near close to the edge of the field. That's better. This field did not catch the edge. All right. This thing is good, and I noticed that the edges are not getting fully taken care of. I'm missing bits, especially with the Puma. I'm not sure why. Maybe the turning radius is a little bit larger. I'm not sure. But I noticed down on that really small field that there's actually a little bit of wheat left over that didn't get harvested either. About that causing a problem next time, so I'm going to go and correct that really quick. Right there. Now, I did plant all the fields with barley this time because I'm totally out of barley. So, oh, it stopped filling because the conveyor needs to be moved. Gonna move this very gently. Let's move it to right there and see how that does. Seems to be working. One thing I learned on Norchholm doing some of this is that these, you can see there, the, whatever the thing is called that's, taking in the silage can only take a certain amount, 20,000 it looks like here. So you can see there's some left on the conveyor, it's slowly pushing it through, and then there's some left in the trailer that hasn't made it through yet. So I'm just going to keep trying to unload the trailer, finish that up, and then let it process for a bit while I go back and do some other things. There we go. Now we're at zero. So I'll go let the trailer fill up and keep working. Now, I think it does process faster if you have time sped up. but I don't want anything else going on if I'm going to do that. So I'm going to go finish fertilizing and seeding. So there's fertilizing going on. Looks like seeding is basically complete. Let's go check this edge of the field. Okay, this edge seems to be okay. I did this one with the dirt squash, so it does, right now, is seeming to be the case puma that's having trouble with the edges. I think I clicked this edge off camera. So yeah, I mixed a little bit with the fertilizer, but yeah, I did clean the edge up. Close enough to refill this sower. Apparently I can. This guy's parked. This guy's ready. That guy's still got 17,000 in, so it's not going to be ready for more silage anytime soon. Let's go keep fertilizing. While we're here, might not be a bad time to expand the farm again. Field 25 does look awful nice. Or does fields 10 and 11 look better? I don't know. I think field 25 would be easier to manage. More square. I think that sounds like a plan. Let's take this guy over. If I can keep selling some silage, I'll get the next upgrade that I want. Let's see how much this field is. Next upgrade I want, I would really like to swap out combines. I'm not real happy with the Neva. I don't like how it misses bits and pieces at the edges. I don't enjoy that combine. So, really like to swap it out. The Rostermarsch is just really expensive. Let's see, how much is this guy? This guy is 127.9, so not really affordable yet. Although, we've got plenty of loan. Let's do that. Hey, we have a new field. question is going to be if the basic hard worker can seed it, or if we're going to need to use some grass to change the field boundaries. Although, if I cut those trees down, I would still have to turn around in it. So let's, we'll do that for a little bit. Let's go, make sure to keep the conveyor belt full. Let's see if we... Oh yeah, if we speed up time, that works a lot faster, obviously. So that might be one way to manage it a little better inside the episode to finish it up. Because ultimately what I would like to do... I started talking about getting rid of the Neva and replacing it, but I didn't talk about what I wanted to replace it with. What I would like to replace it with is this guy. The smaller case, the bigger case would be awesome, but it's $150,000 more. I think the 7130 would be a good upgrade to have that plus the Rostelmarsh. The New Holland would be okay, but I don't know, I just like the case better. That New Holland's cool. But $235,000 for that, obviously needs some money. $235 plus $54, so $290. Call it 300. Not going to do that unless I can get some serious silage sold in this episode. So I'm going to work on that for a bit, playing with the clock to keep this guy. To keep the conveyors full. Okay, this guy is fertilized. Let's see, we've still got to do field 15 and 20. Okay, so he made the turn back there on the square edge. Let's see how he does with the turn down here on the edge that's a little bit tapered. He seems to be handling it okay. That is good. Very cool, so we'll let that keep going. I am going to work on this a little bit off camera, and I will be back if anything interesting happens. See you in a bit. Alright, so I'm back. I don't think I'm going to finish the silage in this episode, just because it's taking a while, and I feel like the episode is already doing alright. 30 minutes right now. I've been wanting to make them a little shorter, so this might be a decent place, but I've expanded the farm, got a little bit of money going on. You can see $226,000, and I've already repaid the loan for this field. So yeah, this is going to be a rather profitable silage cell. I will show you what's going on over there. So got this conveyor set up like this. I showed you the other conveyor. Let's go take a look at it. I don't know what I was thinking. I was trying to push it into the area. This works a whole lot better just pulling it in. Just drag it in next to the wall and deal with it. That's not what I wanted. Deal with it like that. This tractor is barely enough to drag the thing in, but it is enough. So that's good. It's staying full. Not sure if it's going to fill everything from this point, but I'll give it a try. Can report on that next episode. Got everything fertilized at this point. The cedar should just about be done. And that puts us in really outstanding shape for the episode. I'm trying to think if there's any other kind of leftover items to take care of. Not really. Let's go get this guy filled up and call it. We'll check the sales real quick just to kind of see what's going on. Call this guy. Strip that it didn't quite finish, so I'll let that do its thing. Oh, we do have that tree that I chopped down that never got sold. That'll be useful at some point. Keep selling. Let's see how much longer this sale. Oh, we got 4 hours in-game left. That's awesome. Anything else on high demand right now? No. And I don't think I saw any sales come up. Nope. Nothing interesting. I did see a cool set of mods on the Farming Simulator site. They're the classic, was it Classic Pack? That might be what it was called. Not entirely sure. Was available. So you can see it's got all these older style tractors. They're relatively weak, but they're cool. Probably more suited to a small map. I tried this out as a... That didn't work. I need to remove that. These guys were on there as well. I'll post links to this stuff. But, I don't know. These look kind of cool. For different things. This is something I'm thinking about for sugar beets. I think I mentioned that in another episode. But it's got a lot of smaller equipment, you know, more suitable for small farms, but still neat. I might play with that a little bit. This guy looked really cool. It's a 50 bale capacity, if it is accurate, with some kind of conveyor loader. I might try that just for fun. That guy looks neat. And then, of course, the conveyor, the silage compactor, some sheds, that might be helpful, and the skid steers. But the really cool stuff was the classic pack that has all these smaller, older pieces in it that just looks cool. So I'll post a link to that if you want to check that out. It's on the Farming Sim site, like I said. So, yeah, good stuff. I'm going to keep working on this a little bit in between episodes. And at the beginning of next episode, we will hopefully be buying a new combine, because that would be cool. But until then, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button. If you didn't, tell me what I can do better. And thanks for watching. Okay, so not quite done with the episode. finished up everything I could with the conveyors, and there is still... Oh, wrong silo. There's still just a little bit left. So, what I've got to do, see if I can pick it up wherever it is with the bucket. And so I'm just kind of dragging down the middle. Obviously, wherever it thinks it is, I didn't get it. It's here. I ought to be getting it. And no joy. Alright. Let's try down the sides. I had this problem with one of the silos in the Orn home. Ended up not being able to use the silo anymore. Let's try one more down this edge. Which I'm not sure if that was my eye, the monitor, or what, but it looked like the display tried to update, and then let me see how close to this edge I can get. Yeah, it's like the compacting wiggled just a touch. Alright, well, that's really irritating. Not quite sure what I can do with that. I'll keep playing with it, see if I can find it, but, that silo might be useless. Oh well. While we're here, it's worth noting how to take these bands down, or the conveyors down. You can simply hit bait. You can, you know, realign the swing arm and then bring it down, or you can just hit band down. It'll come down, you know, rotated, and then when it hits the bottom, it will. Whoop. Comes back down, it'll knock your tractor over, and but you know, then set up correctly. All right, let's I'm just curious at this point. This is just me playing. There we go. Alright, so now that this guy is probably incredibly damaged in real life, we can go and park this guy. Since I've got so many unload courses that run through here, I didn't want to leave the conveyors in place, considering I'm probably not going to need them for a little bit. But I might keep them close by just in case. And this seems like a perfectly good place to do that. So I'm going to park those there and get this equipment back to the farm. I've got a course that'll do that for this guy. Transfer biogas to farm. Drop that. So this guy, I'm not sure what I'm going to do. Might just see if I can find that last little bit. It seems like I ought to be able to get it. I can just find it. I'm not going to keep the recording going for that whole process. So anyway, I'm going to add this to the end of the other one. This will be the end of the recording. Thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.